Hey, Thomas here. Keeping an overview about all your Azure resources and making sure that they're configured the right way can be challenging, especially if you have a large environment. So it's easy to forget about different security settings for all the resources, to make sure that they're actually sized in the right way so you can be more cost efficient, and many, many other options. But Azure Advisor is here to help. So let's have a look at Azure Advisor and how you can use it for your environment. So stay tuned. Okay. So here I'm in the Azure portal and I'm thinking about like optimizing my Azure virtual machines a little bit. So for that, I'm just have a look at the virtual machine I'm currently using. So you can see here, this is just a standard Azure virtual machine. It's running in my environment. However, I want to know, is it configured in the right way? Is the sizing right? Is there a way for me to save some costs maybe? Did I pay attention to all the security stuff? So there's a lot of things you need to think about. Now, we want to make it easy, and that is where Azure Advisor can absolutely help you. So if you look at the menu here on the left side, you will see here a menu item called Azure Advisor Recommendations. So if you click on that, Azure will basically provide you with recommendations for that specific virtual machine. Now you can see here, there are also different categories. So in this specific virtual machine, I can see here that they're all of the category security, all the recommendations here, but we also have other ones, for example, about cost management and others. So you can see here what I didn't do, like they're also like sorted by impact. So I can see here that I have a couple of high risk changes I should do. For example, like let's integrate disk encryption for that specific virtual machine. It would also tell me to like configure secure communication protocols, but it goes all the way down, for example, to tell me, hey, by the way, you did not configure a backup for that virtual machine. And again, this can be absolutely okay. This can be on purpose, right? So I could also go and say, hey, that's absolutely okay. So I can drill into this and into that recommendation. And then I could say, okay, well, I'm absolutely okay with that. And I could actually go and say, well, I don't care about it, right? And just ignore that. However, very often, you probably not just want to look at one specific resource. So you can here go to your Azure Advisor recommendations for your whole environment. So if I click on this, you can now see here, at the Azure Advisor page, basically, which gives me a lot of different input here. And on the overview page, you can see here, I get cost recommendations and tells me I can save some money here. I have a couple of security recommendations I should take care of. There's also some reliability recommendations. It comes down to operation excellence and performance. So let's dive into some of these. So I promised you this will help me to save some cost. So if I drill into this one, you can see here that I have one which recommends me actually to use a reserved instance, right? So by default, I'm using a pay-as-you-go model. So I pay actually money while the virtual machine is running. Now, if I shut down the virtual machine, I can save money. So that is why we, for example, would do auto shutdown and other tasks during the night when I'm not leveraging the virtual machine. However, I have virtual machines which need to basically run 24/7. And so in that sense, it would absolutely make sense here to buy a reserved instance. And you can see here, the recommendation provides you with some more information on that and how much the saving would actually be. I also have then actions if I'm aware of this, but I don't want to take any action. I could like basically say postpone or dismiss that specific recommendation. Now, if I go back, I not only have cost optimization here, I can also look at the security ones. So you can see here, it's not necessarily about just virtual machines, obviously. I also have that for my subscription environment. I have that for my Kubernetes services and other services which I run in Azure, right? So if I scroll down, you can see here, I even get that like security recommendations for my storage accounts and so on. For example, very simple things like, okay, you have to install like threat protection or endpoint protection on your virtual machines. We also have, for example, let's say, hey, your subscription only has one owner assigned. So if that account is compromised or you couldn't access anymore, you basically cannot access the stuff in your subscription anymore. So it's good practice to preferably have more than one owner assigned, and you get some more information again on that as well. We can also look at reliability. So for example, this one, I have a machine there which is connected using the Azure Arc agent. It tells me I don't have the latest version of the Azure Arc agent installed. To get all the functionality and stability, I should basically do that. I get also some information on operational excellence. So for example, I have a AKS cluster running in Azure, and it tells me basically you could actually go and enable the cluster autoscaler to actually make sure that I have enough resources when I need them, and I can also actually go down if I don't need so much performance anymore. And then also get some performance information here. So for example, I'm also running a unsupported version of Kubernetes here in my environment. So that can obviously impact performance as well. I can then also go out and even set up alerts for this. So if I not just want to obviously go to the portal all the time, I could also just get notified by sending me alerts of my environment. I can also obviously have better versions of like how I want to present this. So I could actually download a PDF or CSV file or create alerts. So I get like as soon as a high level security recommendation pops up, I get that alert sent to my inbox or my Teams channel and so on. So Azure Advisor is really a great way of getting recommendations for your Azure environment. And it's not just about like that you're like a new to Azure and you don't know what you need to look out. It also is for very like advanced and experienced administrators, right? If you're if you're running a large environment, there are a lot of things going on, and you can't be really sure what resources did you have a look at and which resources aren't configured in the right way. So Azure Advisor really is your second pair of eyes to look at your whole environment and give you recommendations based on what's happening in your environment. So I hope this video gave you a short overview about how Azure Advisor can help you to give you recommendations for your environment. So if you liked that video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.